Psychiatric disorders run in families, and they often get passed from one generation to the next. And to understand this better, we're doing a study that looks at both biological factors, specifically genes and DNA, as well as adversity, so environmental factors like difficult home situations, to understand how those two things work together to cause psychiatric disorders in individuals and in families from one generation to the next. So this is a large study of over 550 children, and they were identified before they were born based on their mothers. In some cases, the mothers come from families with social strain of some kind, usually low financial resources. In the other case, the mothers were identified based on having depression or anxiety disorders. So we have two different types of adversity, as well as a number of children who come from families who don't have those adversities, so that we have a comparison. And so what we're going to be able to do is to follow these children right from birth as they grow older, assess them very carefully every year with multiple measures, and ultimately see which kids develop in which ways, particularly interested in, of course, those that develop full psychiatric disorders over time. And we'll be able to look at different pathways and different factors and ultimately develop new preventions based on those new factors that we think will be very, very powerful in preventing many psychiatric disorders going forward. We're just now getting to the point where the data is large enough and the children are old enough to make conclusions. But in general, I can tell you that we have a number of very interesting interactions between genes and different adversities that seem to be predicting aspects of behavior or emotion regulation that we think are going to lead to depression in the future. So for example, one of the things we're finding is that, as expected, children who come from adverse environments are more likely to have a temperament that looks like anxiety or depression might develop in the near future. But only kids with certain genes are truly susceptible to this effect. So kids who come from an adverse environment but have protective genes don't show the same vulnerability as other kids with the vulnerability genes. So that's a good example of how a combination of a certain gene makeup and an adverse environment together leads to the bad outcome rather than one or the other by itself.